Hello and welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today I'm going to be testing an RX3i analog input module. This is an IC694ALG221. It's a 4-channel input, measures current in milliamp, 4 to 20 milliamp, 0 to 20 milliamp. There's some minor adjustments to it. So what I'm going to do first, before I get started though, I want to let you guys know that in order to get this module okay light on, in order to power up this particular module, on the rack that I'm using, which is an IC695CHS0077 slot rack, and also any of the other main racks that you would be using for this type of test, has a power input. It needs a 24 volt DC power input on the rack itself. So to the left of the power supply, there's a terminal strip on the rack that's labeled TB1, and the bottom two screws are the positive and the negative leads for the 24 volt power supply. The very bottom screw is the negative, and the screw second to the bottom is positive. So make sure that you have a 24 volt power supply powering up the rack externally to power up this module. Okay, very important. You won't be able to follow this test if you don't get that. Now, if you do have a good 24 volt DC power supply and you've already got this connected and for some reason you don't get a module okay light on, then that means there's probably something more catastrophically wrong with the module itself, the ALG221. So that's also something to keep in mind. You should get a module okay light if the unit's in good working order. All right. Okay. Now I'm using Proficy Machine Edition, and what I've done is I've opened up a blank file that'll allow me to establish this ALG221 in the slot that it's in. It's currently in slot number 4 because my processor and my CPU are both using two slots, so that is slot number 4 that we're going to be in. And I'm going to configure it by right clicking on slot 4 and add module, or you can double click on slot 4. Go to analog input. We want an IC694ALG221. Okay, now as far as configurations are concerned, there's really none. It's a four channel length, and the address for your reference is percent analog input 00001, or at least it is on the test file I'm using. Okay, and that'll be important when we go to look for where our readings are going to be. Okay, so I'm going to connect up to the processor. Once I'm connected, I'm going to hit that green handprint, which will put me, if you look below, if you're following my mouse here, programmer mode stop disabled. That's referring to the inputs and outputs are stopped. Configuration and logic are not equal, and that's because the processor was doing something different before we've added this ALG221 to the rack. So, for that reason, I'm going to go to online commands, go to clear, and we want to clear controller fault and I/O fault tables. And the reason we're doing this is, as I said before, when we go to download and run, which we're going to do right now, if those aren't cleared and the processor was in doing a different function before, it's going to fault because it doesn't know, hasn't been downloaded yet, and it doesn't know this ALG221 we want to test. So make sure you clear those. We want to download hardware configuration, motion, and logic, which is the top two selections. Okay, another thing that I have while this is downloading that I'm going to be using is I have a 4 to 20 milliamp output generator. It's a fully adjustable generator, meaning that I can dial up and down the amount of current that it's giving me, the amount of milliamps. And the reason that that's good is because we'll be able to test the range and resolution of each channel. All right. Another thing is if you guys look at the wiring diagram for this module, the channels we're going to be probing are 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1 is on screws 3 and 5. 2 is on screws 4 and 6. 3 is terminal screws 13 and 15, and 4 is terminal screws 14 and 16. They're labeled on the terminal itself. Okay, so we're going to start with channel 1. And once we get to testing it, we're going to open up our default tables, analog input. Okay, so I'm going to start by probing channel 1. All right. Now for just this channel, I'm going to show you guys what I mean by dialing up and down the range and resolution and why that's important. Okay, so right now I'm looking at the stability of the channel. Once I've stopped at this value that you see here, 11,712, it's not going up or down by large amounts. It's not fluctuating and fluttering. And then I dial it back up, and I want to be able to get to very close to 32,000, which is the value that would relate to 21 or 20 milliamps. Okay, so the reason it's good to go up and down with the values is because what we typically see most often, or almost every case, with a failed ALG221 or anything that measures current in milliamp, if when it the circuit does fail, it fails at full value. And what that means is, when I touch the probes to the channel, I'm going to touch another channel here, it will immediately go to 32,767. So it immediately goes to the full value of input. And if, try and keep these terminals on, if you go up and down, or attempt to go up and down on a failed circuit, it won't move, it won't change. It'll constantly stay at the 32,767. That's a failed circuit. Okay, it's just so you guys can identify that. So make sure that when you're probing these channels, that you go up and down the range and check the full values and the stability. You need stability in these units as well. And then here's the last channel. Okay, pretty simple. So again, just to recap, things that you want to see: make sure that you power your rack with 24 volts the way it's required. Make sure that there's an okay light on once you do power it up. When the system's all powered up and the 24 volt power supply is powered up, you need to have a module okay light on. Check for channels that fail at full value, 32,767. That doesn't move up or down when you manually move it up or down with your 4 to 20 milliamp generator, and also check for fluctuating circuits that are not stable. Any of those three things, and you have a bad module, needs replacement or it needs repair. Now, we do repair these ALG221s here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products. So if that's something that you guys need or are interested in, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.